Hello students, let's continue with our unit 12, aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acids. In the previous video, we had discussed about the nomenclature of aldehydes and carboxylic acids, and now we are going to do it for the ketones. As we know that for ethers, when we were writing the common names, we were writing the two alkyl groups in the alphabetical order followed by the word ether. And here in the ketones also, when we are going to write the common name, we will write the two alkyl parts in the alphabetical order, and this carbonyl group will be termed as ketone. Okay. And for IUPAC name, we will follow alkane known. ALK stands for number of carbon, ane primary prefix, and ON is secondary suffix. Sorry, it is AN, it is the primary suffix, and this is secondary suffix. So let's start with this. Here, this is the carbonyl part and two alkyl group, and that is methyl. So its common name will be dimethyl ketone. Okay. Now here we are having one methyl and one ethyl. Alphabetically, ethyl comes first, so we will write ethyl methyl ketone. Okay, now here we are having methyl and N profile, so we will write methyl N profile ketone. Now this is isopropyl and this is methyl. So first we will write isopropyl, and then we will use this alkyl group methyl isopropyl methyl ketone. Now here we are having one phenyl group and one methyl group. So we will write methyl phenyl ketone. And students, this is more commonly known by the name acetophenol. Okay, this is having two phenyl groups, so we will write diphenyl ketone. Here we are having phenyl group and ethyl group, so we will write ethyl phenyl ketone. Okay, this is also called as benzophenone, the earlier one where the two phenyl groups were there. So I should write here benzophenone. And this is also called as propiophenone. Now here we are having C6H5CH2 benzyl part, ketone part, again benzyl. So we will write dibenzyl ketone. Okay. And here see students, if you will see this part, this is acetone. Okay. And this is acetyl. So we can write the name acetyl acetone. Okay. Now this is, if you will not see this methyl part, this is cyclohexanone. This is alpha, this is beta. So you will write beta methyl cyclohexanone. Okay, and here for the students, because there are two functional groups, CO it is there and CHO. Keto group it is there, aldehyde group is there. So we will write the IUPAC name directly for this. Okay, so let's write their IUPAC names. In the IUPAC name, first see the number of carbons 1, 2 and 3. So the bond root will be prop. And the single bond is present between the carbon atoms, and the secondary suffix used will be ON. So we will write it prop ane 2 ON. Though it is understood propanone, but more specifically if you are writing propane 2 ON. Here it is 4 carbon, so it will be butane-2-one. Okay. Now here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So pent-2-one. Sorry, here we have not written the primary suffix, so we have to write that also. We should not miss. Many a time students miss this one. pentane to whole. Now here, if you are writing the name, it will be the chain and this will be as a substituent. So 2-methyl. If you are starting because functional group is here, so it will be 3 number, 1, 2 and 3. So the name will be 3-methyl, word root will be a 4 carbon. So it will be butane 2-ol. Okay, now for this one, we are having a chain of 2 carbon and 1 phenyl group is present, and first carbon the numbering will be given to this 1 and 2. So we will write 1 phenyl, how many carbons are there? 1 and 2. So ethane 1-ol. Okay, now here we are having 2 phenyl groups, 1 and 2 phenyl groups, and there is a chain of only 1 carbon. So we will write 1,1-diphenyl methane 1-ol. Okay, methanol bhi likh sakte hain, there is no problem. Here we are having a chain of 1, 2 and 3 carbon, and to the first carbon we are having phenyl group. So we will write 1 phenyl, 1, 2, 3 carbon. So word root will be propane 1-ol. Okay, so its name will be 1-phenyl propane 1-ol. Now when we are writing the name of this compound, we are going to take this chain and again 2 phenyl groups are there. So we will write 1,3-diphenyl propane 2-ol. Okay, now for this one, if we are taking the 5 carbon chain, then it will be 5-pent, primary suffix ane, pentane, 2,3-diol. Why we are writing 2,3-diol? Because on the second carbon keto group it is there, and the fourth carbon, it is 4. On the second carbon keto it is there, on the fourth carbon ketone group it is there, so we are going to take pentane 2,4-diol. Okay, now this is cyclohexanone, and here we have written beta, and when you are writing the IUPAC name, it will be 3-methyl cyclohexanone. Okay, now the last one here, students, as we had studied in class 11th, and when we are having two functional groups, one of them will be junior and another one will be senior, and for the senior we are going to use the suffix, and for the junior you are going to use the prefix. Now ketone group and aldehyde group, out of them aldehyde is senior, so its suffix al will be used, and its prefix, that is keto or oxo, any one you can use. So we will start numbering from here, 1, 2 and 3. On the third carbon we are having ketone group. So we will write down its name, 3-oxo. What, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 carbon. So we will write pent, 3-oxo-pentane-1-al. Okay, so in this way you can write down the names if two functional groups are present. Now we will discuss the structure of the carbonyl group. Okay, now see students, CO group, it is called as carbonyl group. If one side or both side H are there, okay, it can be aldehyde, and if both are having the alkyl group, that is ketone. Now we will study the structure. Here we can see that this oxygen, it is having two lone pairs of electrons. What is the hybridized state of this carbon? It is sp2 hybridized state. Okay, because 1, 2 and 3 sigma bonds it is forming. And when we see for this oxygen, 1 sigma bond, 2 and 3.
2 lone pairs and 1 sigma bond. So this is also having sp2 hybridized state. Okay, now if you see the carbon atomic number 6. So when you draw the structure or orbital diagram, 2s, I'm taking only for the valence shell, I'm not taking for the 1s. 2s, it is having 2 electrons, and in 2p, it is having like this. Okay, so now when this carbon, it is in the excited state, this electron can be jumped, can be excited in one of the 2p orbitals. So now here we are having 1 unpaired electron. Now 1s and 2p orbitals, they undergo sp2 hybridization. Now when you draw the orbital diagrams for carbon, how you will draw, students? This is 1sp2 hybrid orbital. This is 2nd sp2 hybrid orbital. This is 3rd sp2 hybrid orbital. Each is having 1 unpaired electron. And one we are having unhybridized p orbital, and that we are taking as pz. This is pz. And it is also having 1 unpaired electron. Okay, now similarly for this oxygen also we can say it is having 8 atomic number, and in the 2s we are having a pair of electrons, and in 2p, okay, here 1 pair of electrons, 1 and 1. Okay, now it also undergoes sp2 hybridization. Now we will draw similar structure for this oxygen also. Here this is the 1 sp2 hybrid orbital. This one we can take, which is having 1 unpaired electron. Now this is the 2nd sp2 hybrid orbital, that is having a lone pair of electron. And this is the 3rd one, which is having 1 lone pair of electron. Okay, so here we had drawn 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals. 2 are having a lone pair of electron and 1 is having 1 unpaired electron. So they form a sigma bond. Here they are forming a sigma bond. Now it is also having 1 unhybridized pz orbital. Let's draw it. Okay, now this pz orbital, it undergoes sideways overlapping. This is also pz, so it results in the formation of a pi bond, and we can say carbon forming this sigma bond and 1 pi bond between the oxygen. And these 2 sp2 hybrid orbitals, they either overlap with the sp3 hybrid orbitals of the alkyl group or s orbital of hydrogen. Okay, and this is having 2 lone pair of electrons. Okay, so this is all about the carbonyl bond. Now students, when we are comparing the carbonyl, that is carbon oxygen double bond and carbon-carbon double bond, let's compare it. First point, both are made up of 1 sigma and 1 pi. Both are made up of 1 sigma and 1 pi bond. It is also same, made up of 1 sigma and 1 pi bond. sp2 hybridization is present over here. Same here, it is also having the sp2 hybridization. Third point, these are, I'm talking about the similarities. Planar structure, because 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals, they are arranged in a plane. This is a planar, this is also planar. Okay, now fourth one, carbonyl group, they undergoes addition reaction. Okay, now these alkenes, they also undergoes addition reactions. But the difference starts from here. In case of carbonyl bond, students, if you will see, there is a difference in the electronegativities of carbon and oxygen. Oxygen is more electronegative, so the electron pair slightly shifts on the oxygen and it develops partial positive charge and it develops partial negative charge, and it is polar in nature. So in the differences, what we can say, this bond, it is polar, but the alkene bond, it is non-polar, because the electronegativities of two carbon atom is same. Sixth point about the difference, the what we can say here, the addition reaction is taking place in the both the cases, but here nucleophilic addition reaction takes place. Nucleophilic addition reaction, whereas here electrophilic addition reaction takes place. Okay, so here, because this carbon is developing partial positive charge, so nucleophile easily attacks on this electrophilic carbon center. Okay, now this is showing minus E effect, and this is showing plus E effect. Students, if you remember, in class 11th we discussed about the electromeric effect. Let's recall it. If we are having this type of bond, okay, and this pair of electron pi bond, it shifts over here, okay, and in the presence of attacking reagent, this shifting of electron is taking place. Okay, it is a temporary effect. Only in the presence of attacking reagent it occurs. The nucleophile attaches itself to the another atom, okay, which is having the positive charge, then this is called as minus E effect. And let's draw the structure of the product also. Here the nucleophile attaches and this is O developing a negative charge, okay, so this is called as minus E effect. And when we are talking about this plus E effect, in presence of attacking reagent, because we are saying they are undergoing electrophilic addition reaction, when it shifts over here, this H plus, it attaches to that carbon atom or to that atom on which the electron is shifting. So it is showing plus E effect. Okay, so these are the differences and the similarities between the carbon oxygen double bond and carbon carbon double bond. So here I have just given you a brief about the structure of the carbonyl group, students. In the next video we will discuss about the methods of preparation of aldehydes and ketones. Thank you.